All right, how was that for a piece of jumping jive there on the Dancing Party Show? Duke Ellington with Tommy Dorsey and his orchestra from the mid-1940s. 22 before 2 KQAQ time. It's about 36 degrees outside under partly cloudy skies. Now it's polka time once again here on the Dancing Party Show. Here's a polka recording by a local area band, the Viking Accordion Band of Albert Lee, recorded back in the 1930s when they were in their heyday, traveling all the way from Minnesota down to Texas, almost to the Mexican border, playing dance at dates and appearing on records and radio shows. They broadcast for a number of years live on WOI, the Iowa State College Station at Ames, and of course during the 1940s they broadcast on Cape Radio out of Albert Lee over a network of three stations. Recorded sometime during the 1930s, the Viking Accordion Band of Albert Lee with Barbara Polka. As a musician's band when it came to polka music, and record collectors seek their records out and look for them with enthusiasm, because the Vikings are one of the finest old-time bands of the period. Let's go back now to a fine orchestra, a dance orchestra of the 1920s, George Olson and his music, the vocal by Bob Borger, Fran Frey, and Bob Rice. 10 Little Miles from Town, recorded on Victory in 1928. Some of the announcements of church dinners and things coming up before we leave you this afternoon. So while I'm getting ready to read that, you go and get yourself a pencil, piece of paper. While I'm reading the weather forecast, you can write down these dates and phone numbers and so forth if you are interested in attending these dinners and want some of this information. So here's the forecast again for today: mostly sunny, highs upper 30s to lower 40s, winds northwesterly at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, clear and cold. Lows between 18 and 23, winds light and variable. Monday, increasing clouds with highs in the lower 40s, lows 30 to 35. The extended forecast for the period Tuesday through Thursday: Tuesday, warmer, with a chance for rain, highs in the lower 50s, and lows in the lower 30s. Wednesday and Thursday, dry and warmer, highs 60 to 65, lows around 40, normal high is 57, normal low is 36. His high was 42 and the low was 22. A year ago, the high was 42, low 24. We had 3 9/10 inches of snow on the ground a year ago at this time. Record high is 884 in 1950, record low 17 in 1972. Our wind chill this morning was plus 3, according to Rochester Weather Service. They recorded a low of 21, and we had around the low of 23 or so here at KQAQ before I got here, just colder than that. Sunset this evening, 6:21, sunrise. Now this one comes from Glenville. This isn't a church event, but it's something of interest to people in the Glenville area. And it says, attention parents, we'll be having a meeting of all parents interested in forming a parent-teacher organization. We will need to discuss our upcoming big sale fundraiser, which will be held October 25th, and some future projects. The meeting is tomorrow night, Monday, October 19th, 7 p.m. in the Glenville Elementary Library. And we're going to get flu shots. If you think you'd like to have a flu shot, the medical clinic is getting flu shots. That'll be it'll be on Tuesday, October 27th, 28th, at a cost of $7, $8.30 to $4.30, cash payable at the time of the injection. And so that's the story on that. Oh, I've got some more here, too. I want to mention this is my own little notebook here. The Subin Pius Supper at Concordia Lutheran Church. That's west of Albert Lee, just off County Road 46. You go to Albert Lee, you know where the Skyline Mall is. Well, let's take that County Road 46 past the Grayson Cemetery, go west a few miles till you come to the Armstrong Corner. It's labeled there. Then you take there's a sign, I think, that says Concordia Lutheran Church, turn south, go south a mile or two. And there's an old rusty sign in the ditch. You can hardly see it. And it's coming up. And as I mentioned, all these others earlier, but these are the important ones. So we'll hope to see at some of these events. I'm going to try to get to all of them if I can. And like I say, if nobody else goes, I'll go anyway. And I'll go back with seconds and thirds and fourths and so forth and so on. You can do that at all these events. Well, it's getting kind of late. It's 11 minutes now before the hour of 3 o'clock. And I want to mention this next. KQAQ Radio, AM 970, here in Austin, ceased operations on March 15, 1991, due to financial difficulties incurred by the ownership. With the authorization of the ownership, SK Broadcasting had returned the station to the air on a Sunday-only basis on May 5, 1991, in order to air commercial religious broadcast information, entertainment, and keep in touch with our listeners until KQAQ could be returned to the air under a new ownership. Due to the license transition process, we were no longer authorized to operate KQAQ until certain business matters and FCC license transfer paperwork completed. The new ownership now has full authority to operate KQAQ. The new license holders, Mr. and Mrs. Robert Ingstead and Associates, are in the process of organizing the station operations. KQAQ.